stew.
A pinch of salt and laughter too.
A scoop of kids to add the spice.
A dash of love.
It was a normal day in Serena's household when she was watching TV. And something unusual happened. There was a knock at the door.
Hello.
Hello.
My name is Coleman Clark. I'm from the law firm of Dewey, Cheatham & Howe. Anyways, I'm the bearer of news. I don't know. Take it as you will, but I'm sorry to say that, I'll start with the good news. Your sister's boyfriend's roommate's uncle's second twice-removed cousin left you some money.
Oh!
But they died today.
That sucks!
I'm sorry for your loss, but, as fortune would have it, their great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great-great grandfather left you some money, and it was only $25, though.
Oh, well.
Wait, but it was $25 in 1776, so it's probably worth something now. I have a bank statement right here, what it's worth, but I...
Do you need help?
I can't get it, screw it. You know what? Who needs bank statements? We'll do some math!
Come on, let's see how much money I have!
Don't worry, hold your horses. Don't worry, Sarina. You could say my math is perfect.
This is PERT, a formula for calculating interest compounded continuously, just as your relative's bank rate is. P equals the original amount. E equals Euler's number. R is the interest rate. And T is the time in years. He invested $25 at a bank with an 8.5 interest rate, compounded continuously. Wow, that's pretty steep. He invested in 1776, the birth of our nation, and, wow, 239 years in between. So, plug all that into the equation. 25 is the original amount. Euler's number to the rate is 0.085 times 239, and that comes out to be, wow, quite a total, Sarina. Quite a total.
And, Sarina, this is your total! Oh my god, you're rich!
I heard you were off some money. That money belongs to me.
No, that's my money.
No, it's my money.
That's my money.
No, it's my money.
Don't worry, Serena. Don't worry, Serena. I'll protect your money. I'm from Dewey, Cheatham & Howe.
Oh, hey there. I wasn't expecting you! I'm Frederick Peterson from Peterson's Lawn Care Experts. Here at Peterson's, we do not rectangles, not squares, not circles, but triangles. Yes indeed, everybody. We fertilize triangular lawns, yes. And triangular portions of your lawn, yes. And, We're more popular than McDonald's, by the way. They serve billions, we serve trillions. Yeah. See, what we're doing in this yard, I don't know if you can see it, but we're fertilizing a triangular portion of this yard. 25 by 20 by 10. And see how much healthier it looks? I'm sure you can see it. But that's what we do here at Peterson's, and thank you for your time.
Well, hey there.
What even is this? There's not even enough to do with this. It doesn't even stink.
We're doing a commercial. Well, I don't know where you got that, but we actually have high quality fertilizer at only $65 a pound.
So how much will it cost for me to do my triangle?
Well, 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 you see, this is where we do the math to find out the area of your desired fertilizing area.
Here at Peterson's, we use one thing and one thing only. We use Heron's formula. Yes, Serene, that is comprised of the square root of S times S minus A times S minus B times S minus C. A, B, and C, you all are more familiar with, as they are the respective sides of a triangle and a triangle. However, the less popular S value is equal to the average of these values, or A plus B plus C over 2. Now, we have all the values, let's just plug them right in, get our little S value of 27.5. Okay. Now we have our S value and we have all our sides, so now we can just plug and chug right in, yes, sorry, all our equation, and, let's see, we come out with 94.991 square feet. There you have it, folks. We'll probably round up, though, for the cost.
This is a ripoff!
Hey, I'm doing a commercial. Believe it or not, this is a historic moment, because this is the first customer in history who's been dissatisfied with our service.
Your fertilizer's crappy!
Don't believe anything she says. This fertilizer will light up your lawn. Running from Ben Wrong for 72 hours now, although I almost lost track. We're running low on food, we get water, we're thirsty.
Can you just speed this monologue up?
Shut up, please. Okay. We're getting a little irritable here.
Yeah, I literally hate being in this forest.
Sarina, seriously, I'm protecting your... I'll keep my cool, okay? And we're growing a little hallucinogenic, but that doesn't matter. I got a pretty sweet deal on this whip.
Yeah, and I've learned some cool tricks. That was cool, right?
Congratulations, Sarina. Congratulations. Okay, whatever.
Like, you could do better.
You're bad with a machete. Look at this. Okay, and that's her wound. But all is forgiven. All right. But anyways, Ben Wrong's been on heavy pursuit, and
I wanna get you guys!
He's back! We must go further! Sarina, I'm wounded. Go! Take that abandoned shed! We'll lose him!
Is he coming?
I don't know. Hold on. I'll see. We lost him.
I think I hear him coming closer.
I think we're fine. We lost him.
Here's Benny.
Run! Sarina, there's a tree. I think we can run to it.
I wonder if we can climb that tree.
I don't know. Just try.
Let's use math.
What are you doing?
Figuring out trigonometrically. So I know that I'm 5 foot.
Eight.
Four. I'm looking up 50. At a 90-degree angle. How am I going to find the other side? Protozoa, Trochanoa, Sokotoa! I can use tangent because we have the opposite and adjacent side.
Sokotoa. This battle scene is included to portray roughly the same caliber of intensity as the fighting actually occurring around Sarina. For easier viewing, though, I will select a more neutral background. Sarina knows she is 5 feet and 8 inches tall, which converts to 68 inches by multiplying 12 times 5 and adding the remaining 8 inches. Through muscle memory, Sarina knows what a 50-degree angle feels like in her neck, and as you can see, her feet make a right angle with the base of the tree. To find the height of the tree, she must use tangent, because she has the angle as well as the adjacent side length. She is only looking to solve the opposite side length, or the height of the tree. So, we have tangent of theta. Tangent of theta is tangent of 50 degrees, and it equals opposite over adjacent, or x over 68. To isolate x, we must multiply each side by 68. And there we have it, isolating x, and 81.04 inches. The tree is not even 15 inches taller than you, Sarina. You can do it.
Well, if it's only that high, I guess I could climb it. Oh wait, there's a ladder back there. I've been there the whole time.
Gah! I can't get to you. Darn whip.
That's right.
I will get you.
I'm safe. Hold him off, Coleman.
Sarina, I'm gonna draw him off in the distance. You run off that way, okay?
Don't die, Coleman.
All I needed was my reputation, and I have that now. It's over, Ben Wrong!
No, it's not!
I'm a little disoriented. Where's my whip? Oh, my whip's over there. I lost my whip. Okay, oh wow. This tape measure, I'm exactly 16 feet from Ben Wrong. Wow, there's the sword. Okay, I know that Ben Wrong is at a right angle between me and the sword. Wow, this makes a triangle! Unbelievable!
Okay, so I know from this convenient tape measure sitting here, I'm 16 feet away from Ben Rom. I also know I'm 25 feet away from the sword. I can feel it! I also can clearly see Ben making a right angle with me and the sword. This very particular situation calls for literally only one thing. Pythagorean theorem. Okay, it's, how does it go? Oh yeah, a squared plus b squared equals c squared in any right triangle. The c value is the hypotenuse, which is opposite the right angle, therefore the 25 feet is the hypotenuse. Okay, so I know 25 feet squared equals 16 squared plus x squared. Right, so I have to isolate x to find out how far Ben is away from the sword. So, okay, 625 equals 256 plus x squared still. Okay. Subtract 256 from each side. Oh man, running low on food. Okay. 369 equals x squared. Square root of that, 19.21 feet. Gee dang it! Ben's closer to the sword than me. But I'm faster, I'm sure I can get it.
Don't worry, I got him with the machete.
I think I saw that. Good throw. Oh.
Thanks.
Don't worry. I'm not in too much pain. Most of my blood was lost from the machete wound you gave me. So, thanks, Sarina.
Sorry about that.
No, no. Seriously, thank you. Sarina?
Yeah?
Keep the money.